I used to think that I could not go on, and life was nothing but an awful song. But now I know the meaning of true love. I'm leaning on the everlasting arms. If I can see it, then I can do it. If I just believe it, there's nothing to it. I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch the sky. I think about it every night and day. Spread my wings and fly away. I believe I can soar. I see me running through that open door. I believe I can fly. I believe I can fly. I believe I can fly. See, I was on the verge of breaking down. Silence can seem so loud. There are miracles in life I must achieve. But first I know it starts inside of me. Oh, oh, if I can see it, then I can be. If I just believe it, there's nothing to it. I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch the sky. I think about it every night and day. Spread my wings and fly away. I believe I can soar. I see me running through that open door. Can fly. Oh, I believe I can fly. Ooh. Hey, 'cause I believe in you. Oh, if I can see it, ooh, then I can do it.
I can do it.
If I just believe it.
Page before. out the dirty window. Let the sun illuminate.
I'm here standing on the red carpet here this morning representing Youth in Focus as we officially begin the program which is meant to be for today. And to this effect, we have many of our Ifeans who are present here this morning. And to kickstart the event, many of them will be coming up here to show their good looking outfits and also to have one or two words with them on what they are expecting to happen at the event of program. So to say, I say welcome everybody, and not to get off from this place, I want to say Andre to my CEO in person of Princess Foluketa Amola. Okay, I'm having live here on the red carpet two of our important dignitaries with me. Here is Mr. Tony, Barrister Tony Abdullahi, and also the National Secretary to Youth in Focus Initiative. And I'm representing here to have one or two works to with them. So with Barry here this morning, I will be asking, sir, what are we expecting from you since you are going to be one of our guest speakers here this morning?
Yes, I've been told to talk about leadership, though it was not broken down. Leadership is a very broad subject. In the family, you have leaders and all that. So I'll be talking about leadership. I will narrow it down to, because when you talk about leadership, what comes to your mind is political leadership, and we have a peculiar situation in Nigeria today. So I will narrow it down to political leadership and make it as interactive as possible, and take questions and comments.
Okay. Before I come back to you again, let me take it to the national secretary. Sir, I want to ask you the way you're looking this morning. I can see you on a Yifi tie, and to this effect, I believe you are fully ready for this program. Okay, for you to be ready for this program, sir, what are also your expectations for today's event?
Yes, by the grace of God, the maiden edition of Meet and Greet of Youth in Focus Initiative Lagos State Chapter is coming up today, and because of the peculiarity in Lagos State, which is central of excellence, we also expected that everything that is going to happen here today will be excellent. The people, the members of Youth in Focus in Lagos State, I'm going to spring a lot of surprise that everybody is going to see that yes, we are in Lagos State. And to those guest speakers that are also coming, Barrister Tony and Princess of Cambodia, I know that they will talk, that are going to talk about leadership in another way to build our people, the young ones, how to become future leader. Today is going to be a remarkable day in the life of youth.
Okay, thank you, our National Secretary. I'll take it again also to Barry Tony this morning. Sir, looking at your outfit, I was amazed to see you on a walk stick, and I think that should represent the Igbo people of the country here. Yeah. But probably I will need you to explain this better if you are from the west side or you are from the south, etc. So let me just get to know from here.
Thank you so much. Though I'm a high chief, but I'm relatively young. So you can see that I'm so simply dressed, you won't know I'm a high chief. But I am a high chief. I'm holding the walking stick, not because I want to represent culture. No, I had an accident recently, better now. I had the bone at my back broken, it is healed. And the doctors insisted that I should just be supporting my movement with this walking stick. So that is the essence of the walking stick.
Okay, I just pray that God, in His infinite mercy, will heal you completely, sir, in the name of Jesus. And also, I want us to understand here that it is being said that great men don't dress in gold, but when you scratch them, that is when you understand they are made of gold. So I can tell you this morning that I'm highly excited, I'm highly optimistic, I feel comfortable standing with these two dignitaries here. So as I lead them straight to the event where it's going to be happening this morning, thank you, sir, for coming.
Thank you, sir.
I appreciate you.
Thank you.
God bless you, sir. God loves you, God loves us. Thank you so much. Still on the red carpet, here is our beautiful mommy. Actually, I don't know her name, but I can tell you here this morning that she's looking beautiful, and I would like mommy to introduce herself here on the red carpet.
My name is Princess Iwaye.
Oh, that is beautiful. I guess you should be one of our own very guest invitees here today, which is our dignitary. So mommy, you've been here today. I really wanted to know your relationship with Youth in Focus Initiative.
Yeah, somehow I happen to be the host for today's event, and I'm also one of the members of the board of trustees.
Wow, this is beautiful. So you being the host of today's event, are you really ready for all Yifians to come enjoy and have the full fun to the next?
Yes, we are ready.
Okay, so mommy said yes, she is ready. I want to say thank you for being here, and God Almighty will continue to lift you up in Jesus' name. Thank you for coming.
Thank you.
And still on the red carpet, I am Fellow Ayonfe Oluwa. I will be bringing all my beautiful Yifians, everyone, to come on the red carpet. Okay, still on the red carpet here this morning. I'm here with Mr. Fola Adewusio. You can see the man is fully ready for the program. When I'm yet to pronounce the name, he's actually making me understand here that yes, he is good to go. So, sir, you as one of the Yifi, I can see that your own clothes here is quite different and looking beautiful. I can see a tag of M and G. Can you tell us what this M and G represents
meet and
here?
Meet.
Okay. The meet and greet. So you are the committee, or you committee, I want to understand.
Yeah, in our meet and greet, there's a committee that organize all what is going to happen today. And I'm one of the committee. I'm the coordinator in the committee.
Okay.
That is why we are putting on this kind of
thing. So since you are since you are one of the committee for today's event, what should we be looking out for?
Yeah, today is going to be an exclusive event that is going to surpass all the meet and greet that we have so far, even more than the one that took place in Osun State. So today, so many things is in place. We have a guest speaker today, Mrs. Iwayemi Ogomodia and Barrister Dan. They are here to give us some things to know about youth in Bokos, and again, what we youth, what we are supposed to be, and what the people are expecting, what they are looking from us in the near future.
Okay, thank you so much, sir, as the program proceeds.
I'm giving my CEO in person of Princess Toluke Adebayo Nasepsha. She's right there in the United States of America. But I can tell you that we all are today, we are the beautiful people that are all representing her here this afternoon. My name is Fedor Ayofe, the Lagos State Strategic Coordinator, and I'll be your anchor for today. As we start the program from the order, we have the opening prayer. And the opening prayer, we are going to be doing it in two ways. As you all know that this is a non-governmental organization, and we are not trying to be religious by us here. And that is why we are going to be taking the prayer in two ways. And when you look at the word of God, even the Bible, and the other Islamic aspect, it confirmed it that yes, indeed, that the world is created with word. That is, the existence, the creation is with the word. So, on this aspect, we have the heaven and we also have the earth, which is in two forms. So, with this, I'll be calling fellow Bisola to please come and give us the first opening prayer to start the events of today. To please give us the prayer in the Christianity.
Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, let me thank you for this beautiful day to worship and give you honor, adoration for your love and for your kindness in our life. Let me thank you in the mighty name of Jesus. Let me go, you said it in your word that whatever is committed unto your hand, you have the power to keep it to the end. Let me want to start this program, Easy Youth Focus Initiative program, in your hand, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit, that you go before us in the mighty name of Jesus. From beginning to the end, O Lord, come and show your mighty hand in our midst in the mighty name of Jesus. Because we believe in you, you are the only Almighty that can do everything that no man can do. That you come and see us to in the mighty name of Jesus. At the end of today's program, Father, Lord, let us give you thanks and praise at the end in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name I pray.
Amen. Amen. And if so sure you are happy to be seated here this afternoon, your end can still grow louder and better than this. Okay, and it's time also to test our voice right now. Youth in Focus Initiative. I'm not satisfied yet. And that is why I'll take it again. Youth in Focus. Okay, we are just coming up. We are just coming up. I pray that God will bless us more in Jesus' name. Okay, to proceed to this event, I'm a Nigerian. And I love to honor my father's land. In respect to this, for everyone who is present seated, I would like us all to stand up, not for me, for our fatherland as we honor with the national anthem. Please, let's all rise on our feet.
When I say a leader to ensure that everything is put in order. Before today's program, I was here in Lagos, and the first person to get to this place as at 6:30 a.m. this morning, still my daddy. So, our fellow Ifeans, I want us to applaud our national secretary in person of Honor Kumayo Okon Akinyawo. Please, daddy, wave your hands, let me see you. You can see that he is fully represented. The next dignitary is on the I table. I am going to be recognizing here is our very host. Yes. Don't be surprised when I say host, anybody thinking that our CEO, yes. But I can tell you that the person who has put everything yet in order today for us to have fun to the fullest is this dignitary. So ladies and gentlemen, I would like us to applaud our mommy. Yes, let me start with that. Our mommy. And when I say our mom, not just a mommy, also a sister to our able CEO, who is right here in the States. And not just a sister alone, a beautiful, gorgeous looking mother. Honestly, last year, I think we can put our hands together for that. In person of Mrs. In person of Princess. In person of Princess Omolala Olayemi Ogunmedia. Yes, please, let's put our hands together for her. In case she needs to know, she's so beautiful. And another name to mention here, when you are talking about Alibora, when you are talking of Alibora here this afternoon, she still represents Alibora's foundation. So please put your hands together for her. Honestly, there's no word I love saying, great people don't press and grow. But when you scratch them, you discover they are made of good money. I don't know if I can just pull scratch to pick a gold from you. Please go with us. Thank you so much. And also for recognition here this afternoon, I love this man a lot. Yes, I follow him on TV stations. And the last time I was unable to follow him up was on TVC. Yes, then I was also fine. I missed the program. But there is one I was able to witness. That was the one that was anchored in China's TV. And this man was there to talk about today's governance. And at a time when the conversation was growing, then I began to pinpoint one or two things as the program progresses. And at the time that he said, it seems hope and not too aggressive. He was actually telling me. And it wasn't his fault, you know, when you have barristers,
lawyers,
when they are in conversation at a time, it gets carried into the system. So our beautiful influence, I want us to put our eggs together for Mr. Should I say Mr.? No, I'm not going to use Mr. And I'm not going to use Mr. Should I say barrister? Yes, I will use a barrister. But there's one other name I wanted to add here, Chief. And that is why I would say Chief Barrister Tony Daniel. Please, let's put your hands together for him. Yes, and that is here also fully representing today in the YouTube program. God bless you for coming. We love you so much. And the fourth person I'll bring into the eye table, I call her a vibrant youth. Honestly, I love when I see vibrant youth. Youth that are versatile. Yes, youth that can fully represent. So to this effect, I want us to put our hands together for Rachel Adesoya on the eye table. She is also one of our guest speakers who is giving us a brief lecture here this afternoon. Please, let's put our hands together for her. Thank you. Okay, moving away from the big meetings on the eye table, I'm going to be taking it to our full representative coordinators. As I stand before you this afternoon, I would like to recognize the presence of I would like to recognize the presence of fellow Ajibola Abiola or your state youthful coordinator, please signify to see you. Okay, thank you. And also I would like to signify to us here this afternoon, fellow Prince Tai Abitori, Osu State coordinator representing Yifi. God bless you for coming. And also I'll take it straight to Lagos State here. The first person I'll be recognizing on the list of program here is Mr. Badru Abiodun, Lagos State West coordinator, also being represented. And also we have here another coordinator, a very strong Mupu, I call him. When you say a strong man, everything about him is action. And this is a man that I observe so much that believes that actions speak louder than voice. When you see his actions, you understand that yes, indeed, there is something coming out of it. So ladies and gentlemen, I would like to applaud fellow from Lagbade Adeosi, the Lagos State Strategic Platform, we are also one of the committee members here today. God bless you. And also in recognition, I would like to recognize fellow Fobi, our Yifi Facebook and Telegram coordinators. And at the same time again, we have a PA here in person of fellow Bisola, the PA to the CEO of Youthful Focus Initiative. And so to every members that are failing to mention is our name here, we are all fully welcome and recognized. Also, we want to go to our members in Israel. Yes, we have also IFI members, State of America. I just wanted to make us understand something here. When you look at the likes of these girls, not just in one state, we have the one in Canada, we have in UK, we also have in different places. For the last time we had the meet and greet event was when we were able to take this in the borders. So looking at there, you can see from here that our own very CEO is fully represented here in the middle of this. So these are our members, which I will take it one after the other as we look into the first person. This is Elo Tobu from Maryland, U.S., occupation in nurse. And one other thing again, for as many of us that are so active on our social platform, more especially on the Facebook page, you will always find Elo Tobu there. Our nickname is Tobu. In fact, my CEO called her the baby to her in her hand. So thank you for that. Let's have another member here. Yeah. This is Mercy Arell, yes, IFI US Secretary. Very active member also. The last meeting we had yesterday, she was present. And when it comes to distributing messages, information, right from the office of the CEO, you have also here. And the next person is fellow Aminat. This is someone I love so much. When you talk about someone who is so active, someone who at every minute in time, you find her always on the social media, even as 4 o'clock, Aminat is always there. So this is fellow Aminat Yusuf. In fact, she is our recharge card distributor. Can we put our hands together for her, please? And the next person here is fellow Shakira. Yes, I call her mommy also. Mommy can be so funny on the social platform. She drops messages that pertains to parents. And also, she is also a very active member here. The next person here is fellow Oluwatoyin Akinpule from Maryland also. She's also here this afternoon. And the next person on the list of these is who again we have on the projector. Yes, this is Princess Yetunde Olanipeto, or Miss Pudu of Canada. She represents Canada. She coordinates youth in focus over there. So being a coordinator, also fellow coordinators well represented here. I think if we have not gotten a link, today is a better day to link also up with her, as very soon we are going to be looking forward to meet with Canadians here in Movers. Thank you. And the next person here is fellow Monica Ojo, also IFI in the United States of America, Washington, Maryland City. Okay, the next person is who we have here. This is fellow Babatunde Salvador, also a well-represented member. I'm sure many of us that are seated here will know one or two of this individual. And if there's any other person again, we are looking at his fellow Faith, yes, also a well-represented member in the United States of America. And who else do we have on the list? This is Omolola Deborah Oluwafusi, also a member. I can tell you this afternoon that these ones want to see themselves also as part of this program, and that is why we are able to project them here to understand that they are fully represented. And the next person we have here is Princess Foluke. This, and I love my CEO name so much, so that means at times it needs to ring on my head. This is Princess Falake Ogolo. So let's put, okay, when you look at her, so Falake, yes. I want to be very fast. I'm a manager of Falake Ogolo, yes. That is another member in the United States of America. And this who again we have. Okay, brother, I should stop calling the names. I think I've stopped calling the name. What gentle project? Probably to carry my Lord, you pronounce the name, it's me, to understand that my audience are going with me as well. Understand that it is an interactive segment. So who do we have here also again? This is Olaide Watts. Are we here together? Okay, also a member in the United States of America. Do we have any other members? We still need to project it. Okay, this is Jide Watts. Okay, we'll put a scene up for Jide. Okay, this is my own very personal person. to the glory of God. I wanted to see what is happening. But thank God it's in DJ. Okay, the next. We are just getting a picture this one. Okay, we have also Oluwakemi Olajide. Olajide, okay. So a US member, thank you. And do we still have any other person again to be projected? Oh yes. This is Olamide Olatunji. This is Olamide Olatunji, also a US member. And I think by now, this is Damilola, also a US member. And are we done with this? We still have more. Okay, we know what you are going to do for me. Just make it fast. Just ensure we see. This is Olajide. And here is Terry Ade Bayo. And also the last, this should be the last person I'll be projecting. Okay. This is Gideon Ajo Olaoluwa. Oh yes, also a US member. And lastly, this is Baby Dara. Yes, I call her Baby Dara, a proud Ethiopian. You can see the name Ade what? Ade Dara what? Nicole, please let me ask you for this boy. He has been celebrating Jujifi before the meet and greet. And that's why you can see him fully represented, proud if you are on his head and with the logo here. So once again, let's put our hands for our baby if you here, also represented. So to our CEO speech, yes, the founder. And to do this, I would like to hand over the microphone to our own very national secretary, as he will be taking the speech of our founder. This is Esperance together with a standing ovation for our own very CEO in Asensha, as she's not yet fully represented by us. Thank you.
Praise the Lord. Praise ye the Lord. We welcome you once again for this effort-making event that is coming up in Lagos State. It is a joy to see that everybody here are seated, and those that have traveled from far and near come to this place peacefully. We're happy to have you all in good health. Thank you so much. So, our guest speaker today, Barrister Tony. It is a joy to see you, sir, in good health today. Remember when you had an accident that time, the team of Youth in Focus Initiative paid a visit to you in the hospital. At that time, we started praying that God should give you good health. And today, the manifestation is praying. Later today, because if we start today, we will not be able to end. I want to go straight to the speech of our CEO, who is live. Our spirit is with us here live now. She tried as much as possible to send this so that we will be hearing her voice. She will be standing in our presence through the projector, but the system broke down over the night. So it's still a Nigerian problem. She would have loved to see that she's presenting her speech, you know, to us and not through proceed or whatever. But here with us, she has assumed that she is here with us. So our protocol really observed. I am standing here to present the speech of the CEO, the founder of Youth in Focus Initiative, Princess Folunke Ogunlowo Adebayo. In her first paragraph, she said she felt so honored to be here, you know, presenting this speech in her session today to the members of Youth in Focus Initiatives, the Lagos chapter, representing the global world. It is a very great honor to see that people are gathered together from all parts of the country for this kind of event, which is the meaning of it of its kind. You will agree with me that Youth in Focus Games and Great Program has not taken place in Lagos before. And the first that we had was in Osun State, which still lingers in our memory. You know, the organization, the preparations, and all those things. That time, the topic there was on entrepreneurship. And where people that are really made it gather together to give Youth in Focus Initiative lecture. And the CEO is taking a brief from that lecture then, where one of the guest speakers just said, just do it. There are a lot of things embedded in our heart as a youth that you can just take him out. You can just take his head. And so many testimonies have been coming up, especially from that end. This morning, we were engaging with the coordinator of Youth in Focus in Massachusetts, where testimonies are about that one of the youth, one of the members of the Youth in Focus, you know, started garlic processing industry. And that lady is giving testimony now. She's packaging garlic with granules and sugar to students in Massachusetts. And the market is going up very fast. This was taken from that program that we did in Massachusetts. And the CEO said with this testimony that she is also happy to see that another set of youth across the state are gathering here today. People that have made it from one way or the other in their different fields, that they are gathering here today, that he is so happy. The CEO went further to say that the coming together today should be more of networking, that we should be more of, it should be more of interactive, that after today, we should be able to take a deal of what our elder scholars, our legal luminaries, and people that have made it in their various fields of people are going to dish to us today. It is not by accident that we are having Princess Iwaeli Oluwole in our midst. When she talked today, I want to believe that after 6 months, if your life has not changed for better, go and consult God. There is something is wrong in your life. And she's here with us today. She has done it, and evidences have been found in the past. So our princess, the CEO, she's also telling us today that do not lose hope in anything you are doing. Today may be too difficult, it may be, things may be wrong, but be courageous. That courage is what that sustains everybody. And as a youth, whatever that you use your time to do, and the youthful stage, depends, you know, it matters in life, and it determines your future. Our topic today is going to be on leadership. She said, let everybody put herself in a position whereby you can know that you are a potential leader. The moment you know that you are a potential leader, it now goes on you that you should behave very well. She rounded it up that after today's program, that there should be a communique to be written and where recommendations will be forwarded to the Youth in Focus Initiative website. And she now said she's happy that everybody here today and the year is running to an end, that we will all have cause to glorify God and shout Happy New Year come December 31st, 1st of January. Thank you so much.
Yes, guys, so that was for our very national secretary. Yes. We are proceeding and we are still talking about and we are still together here. In no waste of time, I think if the speech to you is a line that I love much here, and this is very powerful here, where she said, as you may be aware, our main objective for today's gathering is to come together to network and to rub minds initiative that can make us competitive, and this absolutely the opportunity to share ideas on opportunities and likely solutions that is required to face the challenge of the 21st century. When you look at the program of events in your hand, where we have in number 8, that is the networking and interactive section. So this is a place or a time now where we get to that very time, we have to look into it. So to proceed here this afternoon, we are going to be looking at the presentation of GIFI objectives. Yes, we want to look at our aims and objectives as GIFI. So to this respect, I would like to take it also to one of our overhead coordinators fully representing Osun State here in person of fellow Prince Tai Adejoyin to please give us the aims and objectives of Youth in Focus Initiative. Let's put our hands together for him, please. Let's applaud. Let's applaud.
Officer, As we all know, the full meaning of its Youth in Focus initiative. And from the word initiative, you realize, you check the meaning, it says, the power and opportunity to act and take charge before others. So that means acting and taking charge before others is a vital component of being youthful. That is, the youth in the past. The economic quagmire that we found ourselves in as a nation today is as a result of the under-utilization of the youth. That's why you're not seeing youth graduates that are looking for white-collar jobs, because we can utilize our initiative. So Youth in Focus initiative as an organization is come to stay, to project the youth, to make them viable, to bless humanity, and to bless our generations. To make sure that the youth are empowered, they're energized, they're encouraged, they're motivated, and they're taken from a level to a higher level to make our community better. If our leaders are prospective, and they have high prospects, they will invest more on the Nigerian youth. And with that, our nation will be able to compete with other nations, the first world nations, the great nations that we have today. So with this, I believe we will talk about one or two things, the vision, the mission. That is actually what it's all about. To empower the youth, to project humanity. Thank you very much.
Our own Osun State coordinator, where we have the first section of elite and Brits. So to proceed this afternoon, there's something that should come up right now, but because of our gift here this afternoon, I would like us to just go straight to the very first speech, which we call a motivational way of inspiring us here this afternoon. So to this effect, I want to hand over the microphone to our own very chief. Look at that word, chief. Away from chief, a barrister. So I think if I have to give you another name, you'd be political. Should I? Okay, let me keep it that way. That's what I'm saying now for our own daddy here, Barry Tony, as yes, okay. You can come outside how you want it to your pleasure. Okay, that is here. Okay, God bless you, sir. That's what I said again.
Thank you very much. I want to make this as interactive as possible. I want to rely on the protocol that has been observed by the last speakers. I recognize the beauty process. I recognize the CEO, the secretary that did a wonderful job summarizing the speech of the CEO, and of course, distinguished the secretary. We have to talk about leadership. Now, youth in focus. What is the meaning of focus? Focus. Concentration, anticipation, expectation. There's this popular saying that the youths are what? The leaders of tomorrow. Because whatever you do now will affect what you are going to do in the future. Now, leadership. It's a very broad terminology. Leadership is the act of leading. That is the meaning of leadership. Now, from leadership we have leading. Who is the leader of the Youth in Focus in Lagos? Is the chairperson or chairman or the coordinator? You see how now sometimes leader or leadership will be. The national leader of the Youth in Focus is who? The CEO. The international leader of the Youth in Focus is the CEO. Now, leadership starts from a micro background, family. Start from the family. The head of the family is the one the good leadership. Before then, I want to define leadership my own way. And I want you to appreciate my definition so that I can come up with your own. Leadership is the act of a person or group of persons authorized or acquiring authority. Take note, in the family, you cannot authorize your dad. It takes authority. So you acquire authority, then authorization. When you vote in somebody, you are giving that person authority. And when the person voted, appoints somebody, he has delegated duties and authority to that person. So leadership is when you acquire authority or you assume authority, either in a forum or in an institution or in a state. What we have there is a forum. Social club is a forum. Rotary club is a forum. Institution, ministries, justice, and all that. State, Nigeria, a nation. Now we narrow leadership to what you all have in mind. When this man comes, we are looking at leadership in Nigeria. And that is what? Political leadership. We are in a democratic dispensation, which means leadership and empowered through democratic process. That is by election. Qualities of a good leader. You will see qualities of a leader, no? Qualities of a good leader. A good leader must, and the person's being led. It's both ways than your leadership. So, a good leader will want to influence those that he or she is leading positively. A good leader must have very good interpersonal relationship. A good leader must be humble. A good leader must have vision. A good leader must have average intelligence. Average intelligence, you don't need to be too sound. You don't need to be too intelligent, but be intelligent enough to appoint those that will help you. And that is what the late Bola Ige did. When he was a lawyer, was a minister of power, but he was able to bring in technocrats. He was able to bring in the right persons to draw a plan for our power situation. So unfortunately, we don't know the details of what happened. But Bola Ige came up with what would have enhanced regular legislative power for the nation. So a good leader is a leader that is able to come up with a vision, draw up a plan for achieving that vision. Other qualities of a good leader. A good leader must lead by example. You cannot tell me that I should be brought to my office, you are leading me, and you will stroll into the office by 12 in the afternoon. A good leader leads by example. Now, when we are differentiating a good leader with a bad leader. I don't need to talk about the bad leader. Let me ask you. Can somebody tell me one good quality of a bad leader? You said we want to make this interactive. Yes.
Arrogant.
Thank you. A bad leader, arrogant. Another quality of a bad leader. Yes. Yes, still part of arrogance, correct. Any other quality of a bad leader? Thank you. A bad leader, even if we all know it's a bad, he becomes worse when he cannot communicate. So, we have talked to some extent about the quality of a good leader, a quality of a bad leader. We've talked about the definitions. You can define a leader or leadership in your own way. We have talked about the evolution of leadership from the family down to forums, down to institutions, and down to the state. We cannot conclude without talking about the state. The state we find ourselves now. people will have good leadership. Some persons we don't have, mark my words. I'm not saying we have bad leadership. We have
good leadership.
And some will say we don't have good leadership. You can interpret it your own way. Now, if majority can say we have good leadership, then the leader is good. And if it is divided almost 50%, then we have a problem with leadership. If you want to step aside so that we can take comments, questions and all that, I want to say that in every democratic society, judiciary, the court, is the last hope of the common man. Anytime there is a tendency to disobey or disregard court order, or for leadership who are supposed to implement or execute court order to select the court order or judgment they want to obey,
it's a big problem.
And the only way we can talk the leaders into taking step to, you know, remedy the situation is not by violence, it is not by force, and it is not by violent revolution. It is continual engagement, continual subtle embarrassment. For instance, if the person submits a court order,
as a lawyer, I will go to the court.
I will go to the court and ask the court to grant an order for the president to be arrested. We know we cannot arrest him practically, but it will be an embarrassment to go to the court to ask. So we continue to protest in a peaceful way. We continue to engage those who are in power in our own ways. And what we have in Nigeria is that any person in government is seen as a blessing to the family. He is supposed to make money, and if he doesn't make money, he is rejected by the family. Until that mindset is changed, we will continue to have a divided position on leadership. I want to thank you so much.
That's, I believe that year has just inspired us. One of the lovers of that word leadership. There was a time we began to understand what leadership is and who a follower is. But I can tell you one thing also here this afternoon, that there wouldn't be a leader without a follower. I don't know if you will agree with me. Hello, am I making sense here? There won't be a leader, there won't be a follower without what? A leader, because a leader should have a follower to govern or to be. So to this, I want to say God bless you for this work.
And also, because of the time, and probably I'm so sure that in a few minutes' time, our parents might be leaving. So if there's any question, let me just treat that aspect with immediate effect. If there's any question for our parents here afternoon, I would like us to signify if we have one or two questions for him. And if we want to put our own in written, probably it is also allowed. So I think I'm having one. Do I still have any other person making it too for the question here this afternoon? Is there still anybody who is here to ask question? I'm still having one. I am believing we should have about 2, 3, or 4 for question here. Okay, let me take it straight to my own very assistant coordinator, fellow Ty Adejoy, for his own question.
Thank you very much for the food. Talking about leadership, and my question goes to us, to you. I want you to help us out. Now, he said, we are the leaders of tomorrow. And I think he wasn't happy with that. We want to see ourselves as leaders of today. Because in one capacity or the other, we have started leading. And
check out those prosperous countries apart from Nigeria, they've been involved with us in their leadership activities. Now, my question is this, Nigeria as a case study. We have youthful leaders who have come out to say they want to lead us. And when we entrusted our destinies into their hands, permit me to mention this, sir. Jaya Bello of Kogi State. We saw against terrorism. We saw every other thing that happened during the election, bad videos and via other platforms. Now, Shomoreto, there, somewhere, and we saw how his AAP lies with the then the present minister, the then governor of the state, and the president of the candidate. So, now, Femi Falana too, supported the removal of Oroge. So now, my question is this very briefly, sir, before I drop the mic. How do we know the leader to follow, the right leaders to follow? How will their early conceptions, perceptions, not swap us away from the line of truth? Thank you, sir.
Should not send any pressure. There's only one person that raised the hand. When people should say, if you don't ask pressure, you bring 20,000, everybody else will be up.
Now,
you see, Nigeria is a peculiar state. But I am very, very sure that Nigeria will be great. Now, to convince you that Nigeria will be great, Nigerians are leading in almost every aspect of global activities. The best computer, you are the best, youngest computer scientists in Nigeria. It's in the US. One of the best nuclear scientists is in Nigeria, is in the US. May it interest you to know that when UK organized their Olympic, if you watch the security arrangement, it was digital. There were no, we don't see so many policemen, but everywhere was tight. Nigerians were in charge. It was a computerized security system. Now, I will say this. What we need in Nigeria, and if you follow my program, that's what I've always said. Once electricity works in this country, electricity, you know how much we are saving? We are saving not less than 30 billion per month. And this 30 billion, is not going to be in government hands. It will be me and you. We are the one buying generator, buying fuel, maintaining generator. That will add to your power, I mean your fund for investing. Then, infrastructure. Once they take care of infrastructure, and we are putting pressure on them, finally, security. Once these three things, we take care of them. Look, the last property I bought, somebody was staying there. I have an office in Ghana, you build that with me. He said, Nigeria, do you know what he's doing? Research on how to use waste to generate energy. Apart from practice, I do one or two other small business. I import apples from Indians in South Africa. And you know what they told me? They said, this is our road, Lagos by the road. There is something that will put on it. As far as vehicles are running on it, it will be generating energy. The moment we find solution to power, we find some level of solution to security. And let me tell you, even security, we are already taking the initiative. Because in your street, you have your community meeting. You are taking care of that. If every street in Nigeria is doing that, we are helping the government. And I suggested to Lagos State government, you can do the most in Lagos State if you are sincere. From where you are, from your compound to the middle of the street, the other man's compound to the middle of the street, from your gate, do it, you do this. Government can encourage you. Give you a prototype. Encourage you by waiving off taxes and the rest, just like they did for Dangote. Dangote is doing a papa room, and they have waived tax for 10 years for me. And that is billions. So you can encourage people by saying, don't pay your, land use tax or social period. This is the prototype. Do the front of your gate, up to the middle of your room. All street will be tagged. Sometimes I don't know if it is not the same brain we have that knows the government has, but we must continue to turn back to oppression. We must continue to engage those who find themselves in the position. While we ourselves, we try to get in. What we are doing now is that the youth are criticizing. They are not participating. They are feeling that you need money to participate. They are afraid of the violence that are tailored on elections in Nigeria. Remove fear from your mind, participate, and how do you do it? Efforts. That is why when we leave Nigeria, we are performing well outside. When I was coming from Akan, I used to do. But now, if you put me in a place where there is regular line, air condition, everything, I will say that's what they say. So that effort we must put in as youth to take over power. And what you do, if you need to bend the old man, we have some people, I'm not mentioning people, but when you get in, please do the right thing. It will be difficult to say that the youth have been empowered enough to move. No, they might be saying the federal government gets solution to the three major ideas I mentioned. The youth will be naturally empowered. So what we do is we continue to engage those in power, we continue to talk to our people, the members of the State House of Assembly, National Assembly, they live among us. Talk to them, engage them. That is the best we can do for now. We were able to tackle Ebola by ourselves. If we can take care of that jointly, it shows that the unity of Nigeria is not the issue. By the grace of God, the youth will take over. Thank you so much.